Some fighters like to win, others don't care as long as they get paid. There are also the fighters who forgot the meaning of the word victory. Welcome to our list of the worst MMA records. Number 7. Joe Son. Alright, this man could easily be the biggest comedian of the UFC. In his first fight with Cade Hackney at UFC 4, he wrote the history of MMA as the guy with the biggest nuts. Son trapped Hackney into a standing guillotine choke, but when the fighters fell to the ground, Cade landed few brutal shots to Joe's family jewels to slip out of the submission. Nut shots were allowed at that time, and Son lost the match via TKO. Son's score is 0-4. He lost all his fights. Joe is also known for his fighting style, Joe Son Do. Well, actually nobody knows what that means. He is also defeated in his second match back in 2002 at Pride, the best volume 1 via submission. He was finished in 3rd and the 4th match too. In his only kickboxing match, Son lost to Nobuaki Kakuda. But here is the weirdest thing. Son even rocked Japanese fighter after a great hook. Joe Son serves the life sentence in prison for rape and murder. He is also ranked high on the list of the worst MMA records. Number 6. Akebono Taro. A retired American-born Japanese sumo wrestler is a master for negative MMA and kickboxing scores. He weighs 500 to 550 pounds, 225 to 245 kilograms, and he is a real giant with 6 foot and 8 inches, 203 centimeters. You don't expect from such a man to go down like a wrecking ball every single time. Yet, his shameful MMA score of 0-4 and kickboxing 2-8 speak for themselves. Akebono lost 4 fights in a row, and he has never won an MMA bout. He worked hard to get a high position in the list of the worst MMA records. He was defeated to Royce Gracie, Bobby Olagan, Don Fry, and Giant Silva. 3 of his MMA losses came via submission, 1 via decision. Royce Gracie was 3 times smaller than this guy, and Akebono had a clash with the Brazilian K1 Premium Dynamite 2004 on December 31st, 2004, New Year's Eve. When both fighters went down, everybody expected a TKO finish from Akebono. Yet Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu experts finished the fight with omoplata instead. When it comes to kickboxing, he was knocked out by Bob Sapp and Remy Bunyansky. Right high kick at the elimination of K1 World Grand Prix Final Elimination 2004 is still a strike to remember. The Flying Dutchman put the 550 pounds mountain to sleep after such a brutal and precise shin. Hongman Choi won him 2 times via TKO. But Akebono avenged when he put the Korean giant to sleep at K1 World Grand Prix 2006. Well, it could have been the clash of two, let's say, heaviest and biggest fighters. Number 5. Jonathan Ivey. Jonathan Ivey made his MMA debut in 1998. He won the first 2 matches. It looked like he's a new rising star. But it was such a mistake. Until now, Ivey has scored 55 wins, 79 losses. He had the last match against Travis Fulton at Coliseum Combat 45 on June 30, 2018, which he lost via TKO, retirement. His card is his weak spot and the ultimate reason for his high place on our list of the worst MMA records. He lost 16 times via decision. Big John earned a 7 fight win streak in 2006, but also lost 7 times in a row from 2012 to 2014. He had ups and downs, but his career lasts for 20 years. Jonathan Ivey doesn't even think of the retirement. Number 4. Shannon Rich. Shannon Rich is not a big name of MMA. He fights since the year 1998, where he earned a score of 55 wins, 80 losses and 4 no contests. His fight has never gone to judges' scorecards or decision, and he's unique by that parameter. In 2001, Shannon Rich set a negative record of 13 losses in a row, a legend of the worst MMA records. He was bettered by many MMA legends, Diego Sanchez, Dan Severn, and Kazushi Sakuraba. Each one of them won him so easily. Most of his fights were ended in the first round. His cardio has always been his weakest parameter. Shannon deserved high ranking in the list of the worst MMA records. Rich is also an actor who appeared in an episode of Walker, Texas Ranger. He lost in much prominent organization during 17 years of his fighting career. The most known ones that signed him were Pancrase, WEC, and Pride Fighting Championship. Oh, some people accused him of fixing fights. and he even earned the suspension in 2006 because of that. Many even today believe his fight against Dan Severn was fake as fuck. Number 3. Bob Sapp. This man is one of the biggest fakers in the history of mixed martial arts. A 6 feet 5 inches 196 centimeters tall giant who weighs around 340 pounds 160 kilograms gets KO'd by so many smaller fighters? Wait, something looks weird. I mean, he came from the American football, so you don't expect a technical performance, but he's 10 times stronger than many rivals. Sapp acted in many movies too. He is one of the funniest names in MMA and the owner of the worst MMA records. In the career's beginning, the Beast used his size against his smaller rivals. He was trying to win, but problems were appearing when he'd be taken to the ground. He had high quality matches versus some of the biggest names. I just remember his spectacular wins over a former kickboxing champion Ernesto Hoost. Sapp taught him a lesson two times in 2002. Until now, Bob Sapp has earned an MMA score of 12-21. From March 11, 2011 to September 13, 2018, the Beast didn't walk out of the ring as a winner. He lost 14 fights in a row, all in the same way, tapping out as soon as his hand reached the mat. Luckily, he scored a unanimous decision victory over the former sumo wrestler from Egypt, Osuna Rashi, at Rizin 13. The 45-year-old fighter is still under contract with Rizin Fighting Federation. He remained worldwide known as a man who was using brute force to win the clashes. Most of his wins came against small Asian men half of his size. For example, Kiyoshi Tamura, his rival at Pride 21 on June 23rd, 22, weighed only 198 pounds, 90 kilograms. I doubt some heavyweight competitor will overtake Bob Sapp in the list of the worst MMA records. Now let's take a look at his kickboxing streak. He holds a record of 12-19. On New Year's Eve 2015, he won a 550-pound sumo wrestler Akebono from Japan, but the fight looked more like a pushing festival. Mirko Crocker broke his orbit on bone at K1 World Grand Prix in 2003 after not-so-strong left cross. Number 2. Jay Ellis. Jay Ellis started his career in 2005. He lost 4 fights in a row and he was better in each of them. But he is a stubborn man who pursued his dream of being a professional MMA athlete at all costs. Ellis has a total score of 15 wins and impressive 73 losses. He still competes on a regular basis. What is this guy made of? Most of his wins and losses came via submission. Ellis was also TKO'd 20 times, a real master of worst MMA records. Oh, Jay Ellis is surprised when he wins. Sometimes he forgets to release the submission on time. Let's hope he won't follow Rosimir Polhara's steps. His longest losing streak was between 29 and 2012 when he left the octagon as a loser 18 times in a row. He likes a quick paycheck. That is probably the biggest reason he continues to battle over and over. Number 1. Kenneth Allen. Some people love blows to the head. Kenneth Allen is the owner of the 139 MMA score. He won only once in 40 fights. His matches were in smaller promotions. Allen is also the owner of one of the worst MMA records in the history of this sport. Kenneth Allen made his professional debut back in 2005. This welterweight competitor had a clash against UFC fighter Jack Ellenberger in March 26, which he lost via armbar. His only win occurred against Corey Simpson at MCC4, the rematch on July 15, 26 via rear-ranked choke. He hasn't won for over 12 years. He confessed that he mostly fought on short notice and rarely trained for his fights. Kenneth Allen also said that if someone pulled out, he was the man who stepped in immediately. Kenneth was always ready to accept any opponent. Also, if somebody called him to fight, Allen didn't have the common sense to say no. Allen is on a 27-fight losing streak. The most of his losses came via submission. He is the highest-ranked welterweight fighter on our list of the worst MMA records and also the negative champion. It is never easy to get a high ranking in the list of the worst MMA records. I mean, you should be an insane man who fights despite all the losses, or the guy with the ultimate power of will. What kind of fighter you are, it purely depends on you. You think it is easy to lose most of the matches? Leave the ring with your head down every single time? Congrats! You know nothing! These fighters should be celebrated more than champions. The power of their minds knows no limits. If you agree or disagree with our comments. If you agree, disagree with our threads, please leave comments, visit us, subscribe to our channel, and please visit us and best top list bg.com.